And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him, whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved.
Israelites, the Most High has his ways of communicating with his people. Yah used several methods to show the remnant his sovereignty. The Most High used great miracles in the past and present to reveal his power and dominion over his creation. There are times the Most High show us who he is in a subtle way. The scriptures reveal to us that in the last days, knowledge would increase.
But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased.
Indeed, knowledge has increased. The great awakening is revealing truth and setting many free. The word of the Most High said, "The truth shall make you free." It is through the awakening many people's knowledge has increased. The beast system called the times we are living in the information age. Anything you want to know, you can find out. While we are living in the time of the Great Awakening, it is important for the people of the Most High to use discernment. The kingdom of darkness will look for clever ways to deceive you. There are many that are being deceived and misled by the kingdom of darkness, lying wonders and imitations of the Most High's prophecies. If the people of the Most High allow their Elohim to lead, they will not fall for the kingdom of darkness deceptions.
A man's heart deviseth his way, but the Lord directeth his steps.
The time has come for the people of the Most High to believe their Elohim. Instead of waiting on great signs and wonders, look for the subtle ways the Most High is communicating with his people. The Most High used signs, and if needed, great wonders to wake up his people. It is important for the people of the Most High to not become dependent on seeing great wonders from the Most High to believe it is Yah behind the scenes fighting for his people. It is the Most High behind the scenes helping his people achieve their greatest goals and the minor accomplishments many look past. When your ways please the Most High, he will help you. When the Most High sent Yahshua to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, many Israelites thought the Messiah was coming with a great army to destroy the nations like the heathen nations they covet. When the Messiah made his grand entrance, he came riding on a donkey with no visible army.
All this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the prophet, saying, "Tell ye the daughter of Zion, behold, thy king cometh unto thee, meek, and sitting upon an ass, and a colt, the foal of an ass."
The Messiah's meekness displeased many. Because of his subtle ways of presenting himself as the Messiah, many did not believe he was the Messiah sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Because the Messiah did not come the way the people expected, he was looked at as only the son of the carpenter by his people.
Is not this the carpenter's son? Is not his mother called Mary? And his brethren, James and Joseph and Simon and Judas, and his sisters, are they not all with us? Whence then hath this man all these things? And they were offended in him. But Jesus said unto them, A prophet is not without honor, save in his own country and in his own house.
Israelites, the reason you should not solely depend on great signs and wonders to believe it is the Most High behind the scenes, acting on the behalf of his people, the scriptures reveal to us in many verses about the kingdom of darkness imitating the Most High by doing great signs and wonders to deceive the people. The book of Matthew revealed to us in the last days, false prophets and false messiahs will appear and deceive many with signs and wonders. The verse went on to say, if it were possible, they would deceive the remnant.
For there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that, if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect.
The kingdom of darkness imitations are so believable that if the Most High did not preserve a remnant for himself, the very elect would be deceived. If the indigenous black people are not careful to look behind the scenes to identify who is doing the great signs and wonders they are witnessing, many will be deceived by the kingdom of darkness imitations of the Most High's prophecies. So far, many believe the kingdom of darkness when the synagogue of Satan imitate the regathering of the Israelites. Instead of gathering the real blood descendants of Jacob, the Israelites, the synagogue of Satan gathered the tares from certain parts of this world to place on their stolen land to imitate the regathering prophecy of the chosen people, the Israelites. The Most High has yet to gather the chosen people from all over the world.
And I will be found of you, saith the Lord, and I will turn away your captivity. And I will gather you from all the nations and from all the places whither I have driven you, saith the Lord. And I will bring you again into the place whence I caused you to be carried away captive.
If the gathering of the chosen people was prophecy fulfilled when the synagogue of Satan gathered the tares, why are the Christians waiting to be gathered? According to religion, the so-called Christians supposedly replaced the chosen people, the Israelites, by becoming spiritual Israel. How come the synagogue of Satan did not gather spiritual Israel? Anyone who read the scriptures should know that the Most High said when he gathered the tares, he will gather the tares first to burn them.
Let both grow together until the harvest. And in the time of harvest, I will say to the reapers, gather ye together first the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them. But gather the wheat into my barn.
Discernment is key in the last days. The scriptures reveal that the Most High would never forsake his people, his inheritance, the Israelites.
For the Lord will not cast off his people, neither will he forsake his inheritance.
In 1948, the synagogue of Satan stole land in the Middle East to create the state of Israel. They used the gathering prophecy to accomplish their goal to control the Middle East. The kingdom of darkness imitate prophecies to gain control and to increase its army in the physical realm. Because the synagogue of Satan was successful in stealing land in the Middle East, many mistake their success for the Most High protecting and providing for his chosen people. Because of the great wonders the kingdom of darkness did in stealing the land, the people automatically associate the lying wonders with the Most High. The scriptures made it clear that Satan deceived the whole world.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceiveth the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him.
The synagogue of Satan was able to create the state of Israel through powers they received from the kingdom of darkness. It is extremely important for the people of the Most High to know that the kingdom of darkness can do signs and wonders as well. Israelites, beware of Satan's lying wonders. The workers of iniquity will do great signs and wonders to deceive many. The power behind the workers of iniquity, giving them the ability to do great wonders, are evil spirits.
But they are the spirits of devils, working miracles, which go forth unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world to gather them to the battle of that great day of God Almighty.
The workers of iniquity made sure to serve their idols according to their God's desire to receive the power to do as thou wilt. The powerful heathen nations are supported by the kingdom of darkness. Their leaders receive power from their God Satan to overpower the indigenous black people as well as the Gentile leaders who do not comply with the kingdom of darkness agendas. It is time for the people to stop mistaking the signs and wonders done by the kingdom of darkness with the Most High. Right now, the kingdom of darkness is imitating the mark of the beast. The synagogue of Satan's imitations of the mark of the beast is a cover up for their true intentions. The imitation of the mark of the beast is the kingdom of darkness' way of ushering a new era. An era where the workers of iniquity are merging men with machines. This is done with the synagogue of Satan's advanced technologies. The beast system call it the human 2.0. I hope you're beginning to understand the reason it is important to the synagogue of Satan to jab as many as possible. How else are they going to mix iron with miry clay? They use the prophecy, the mark of the beast, for control and to overshadow what they are trying to do, which is combine men with machines. Because many do not read for themselves, they perish from a lack of knowledge.
Quote, but the idea that human brains and computing machines will be coupled together very tightly, right, was an idea of his from 1960. And I would argue that we are not quite at this level of human-computer symbiosis yet. But I think we are approaching it very quickly. Right now, I think the investment in this man-computer symbiosis is actually well below where it should be. And I'm going to make the argument for our centaurs that this is the place that we both need to invest, build, and think about sort of the future implications.
Therefore, my people are gone into captivity because they have no knowledge, and their honorable men are famished, and their multitude dried up with thirst.
The synagogue of Satan is aware that the people know of the mark of the beast prophecy. The workers of iniquity know that the people will rely on their faith to overcome the mark of the beast instead of fighting against the new world order. The people that are held hostage in religion allow the synagogue of Satan to still land in the Middle East because they believe that was God helping the chosen people and the scriptures are being fulfilled. Only those who knew the truth fought against the kingdom of darkness. Because many are trapped in religion, the new world order, a kingdom that will be established through technology, shall come. The scriptures spoke in the book of Daniel about the kingdom made with iron and clay.
And soon thereafter, you won't just wear technology, but you'll ingest it. Smart pills powered by your body, using the same principle that allows a potato to power a light bulb, will monitor your vital signals for up to 72 hours, and it'll provide real-time insights on your health wirelessly to your doctor. And if this sounds a bit science fiction, it's already received FDA approval, and it's expected to be released in late 2015. So if that wasn't weird enough for you, Body 2.0 will include artificial eyes.
And whereas thou sawest iron mixed with miry clay, they shall mingle themselves with the seed of men, but they shall not cleave one to another, even as iron is not mixed with clay.
Many indigenous black people do not have the Holy Spirit to reveal truth to them. That is another reason they are dying in the beast system. Remember, only the Spirit of the Most High reveal truth and tell you the things to come. If the people in religion took the time to read the scriptures, they would soon realize that they are being deceived in the churches as well as in all religion. Because Satan has blinded their eyes, it is difficult for them to see the deception. Due to their blindness, many of them are lining up to become lab rats in the beast system. The scriptures was telling the truth when it said, "The God of this world has blinded their eyes that they cannot perceive nor believe the truth."
In whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them.
The Most High gave his people signs and certain events to look for before certain prophecies can be fulfilled. It is important for the people of the Most High to know the order of when the prophecies are to be fulfilled. We know that the kingdom of darkness has already imitated the gathering of the chosen people. Now the kingdom of darkness is imitating the mark of the beast prophecy. Many indigenous black people, as well as the heathens, believe the kingdom of darkness false imitations of the prophecies. The gathering of the chosen people is after the mark of the beast and the tribulation. I believe the kingdom of darkness will use the judgment on the nations from the Most High as the battle of Armageddon prophecy to continue to deceive the people. This could be the reason to why many will not repent despite of everything they have seen in the last days.
And the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues yet repented not of the works of their hands, that they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. Neither repented they of their murders, nor of their sorceries, nor of their fornication, nor of their thefts.
Israelites, the timeline to when certain prophecies should occur is important. If the people do not know the order, they will accept anything that appeared to imitate what the scripture said about the prophecy. For example, the mark of the beast. We are living in a time, if you don't take the jab, you cannot enter certain places. Israelites, before we get to the mark of the beast, the great tribulation, the false prophet, the 1,000-year reign, and the other prophecies, the two witnesses must come forward. It is extremely important to not look to great miracles, but look for the subtle signs the Most High gave you to know what time we are living in. We cannot have the mark of the beast without the two witnesses. After the two witnesses complete their assignment on earth, the other events will come at the appointed time.
And I will give power unto my two witnesses, and they shall prophesy 1,260 days, clothed in sackcloth.
The word of the Most High said, two or three witnesses confirm a matter. The Most High did not say to his people to wait for great signs and wonders to believe him or what to expect in the last days. The Bible actually warned us of the kingdom of darkness, lying wonders. The people of the Most High must graduate to the level of not needing great signs to know it is the Most High behind the scenes. Confirmation comes with two or three witnesses.
This is the third time I am coming to you. In the mouth of two or three witnesses shall every word be established.
The witnesses that shall come forward to confirm a matter are people who had no previous knowledge of what the Most High discussed with you or showed you in a dream, vision, a message, or a testimony. The witnesses the Most High will use to confirm something to you had no conversations among themselves about the word the Most High sent to confirm to you. The witnesses can be people you know or people you've never met. I've had people tell me they received confirmation from the messages I posted. I've never had a conversation with them about what they are believing the Most High for. Sometimes the witnesses don't know they are giving you confirmation. One way the Most High will not use a person to confirm a matter is when the so-called witness say, God told me to tell you. The God they are speaking of are the familiar spirits revealing things about you to them. Be careful of the man or woman of God that say to you, God said. Israelites, know that the Most High did not say it.
And her prophets have daubed them with untempered mortar, seeing vanity and divining lies unto them, saying, thus saith the Lord God, when the Lord hath not spoken.
The prophets or individuals that say, God said, are high-level workers of iniquity in religion, looking for ways to steal from you. Do not believe them. The scripture revealed to us, in the last days there will be two witnesses. The scriptures went on to reveal their purpose and what shall befall them. The two witnesses the Most High will send before the mark of the beast and the gathering of the Israelites is a subtle sign to help his people know the hour they are in. Therefore, knowing the Most High timeline should be a priority to you. This will help you prepare for what is to come. I hope this generation is not the generation that is asking for great signs and wonders to believe the Most High. The scriptures made it known that none will be given.
The Pharisees also with the Sadducees came, and tempting desired him that he would show them a sign from heaven. He answered and said unto them, when it is evening, ye say, it will be fair weather, for the sky is red. And in the morning, it will be foul weather today, for the sky is red and lowering. O ye hypocrites, ye can discern the face of the sky, but can ye not discern the signs of the times? A wicked and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and there shall no sign be given unto it, but the sign of the prophet Jonas. And he left them and departed.
The scripture said, blessed are those who do not need signs and wonders to believe.
Jesus saith unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen and yet have believed.
The people who have accepted the beast system and its culture are always looking to great miracles and wonders to confirm scripture. They will not believe anything unless they see signs and wonders. Israelites, do not be like them. The Most High communicate with his people in a subtle way. The word of the Most High combined with the Holy Spirit is all that you need to overcome the lying wonders from the kingdom of darkness. Stop looking to great signs and wonders to believe.
Then said Jesus unto him, Except ye see signs and wonders, ye will not believe.
If you are looking for fire to come down from heaven to burn the heathen nations like the Most High did with Sodom and Gomorrah to believe the Most High, you will be waiting for a long time. The false prophet, most people know as the Antichrist, will have the ability to do great wonders. By the way, the scriptures have many names to identify a person. Knowing the names are just as important. For example, the chosen people have several names: the Israelites, the children of Israel, the southern kingdom of Judah, the northern kingdom of Israel are a few names that identify one nation of people in the scriptures. I've had someone say there is no man of sin, just the Antichrist. The Antichrist, the false prophet, and the first beast are the same entity.
And I stood upon the sand of the sea, and saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having 7 heads and 10 horns, and upon his horns 10 crowns, and upon his heads the name of blasphemy. And he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle, and them that dwell in heaven. And it was given unto him to make war with the saints, and to overcome them. And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. And the king shall do according to his will, and he shall exalt himself, and magnify himself above every god, and shall speak marvelous things against the God of gods, and shall prosper till the indignation be accomplished, for that is determined shall be done.
The men of sin, the son of perdition, will force many to worship the first beast as well as force the people to take the mark of the beast. Like the first beast, the second beast has many names. The Bible said the second beast will have the power to bring down fire from heaven. The second beast will have the ability to do great miracles and wonders that will deceive the people. Israelites, do not associate every sign and wonders with the Most High.
And I beheld another beast coming up out of the earth, and he had 2 horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon. And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men, and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by a sword and did live.
Another example I would like to give you is Satan. The Bible identifies Satan with multiple names: Lucifer, devil, the dragon, the serpent, the beast, the Messiah that came in his own name are a few names that identify your adversary.
And I saw an angel come down from heaven, having the key of the bottomless pit and a great chain in his hand. And he laid hold on the dragon, that old serpent, which is the devil and Satan, and bound him 1,000 years.
The only way you will gain understanding and to better understand the scriptures is by asking the Most High. When the Most High wants to do something in your personal life, he will send you confirmation if you need it. Not everyone is on the same level. Like I said before, some of us do not need the 2 or 3 witnesses to believe the Most High or to act on what we believe the Holy Spirit is telling us to do. For those who need the confirmation, the Most High will send the 2 or 3 witnesses to confirm the matter.
Ye lust and have not, ye kill and desire to have, and cannot obtain. Ye fight and war, yet ye have not, because ye ask not.
Another way the Most High communicate with his people to reveal his intentions, the Most High does the same thing twice. If the Most High show you something twice, this means what you saw shall come to pass swiftly. The matter has been confirmed, you must prepare. The book of Genesis revealed to us that when Pharaoh had the exact dream twice, Joseph, the son of Jacob, interpreted the dream for Pharaoh. Joseph made known to Pharaoh, because his dream was doubled, the Most High is confirming what he has established. Israelites, whenever the Most High reveals something to you twice, that is another way the Most High is giving his people confirmation.
And for that, the dream was doubled unto Pharaoh twice. It is because the thing is established by God, and God will shortly bring it to pass.
If the people of the Most High know how their Elohim operate, they do not need to look to the beast system or anyone for answers. The Most High will reveal his intentions to his people, as well as warn his people ahead of time to prepare themselves and their family. As the awakening is in full effect, it is the job of the remnant to remain vigilant and prepare accordingly. The kingdom of darkness will try to deceive you. The scripture said the remnant will not be deceived because the Most High is preserving his elect. For you to not be deceived by the kingdom of darkness, you must obey the Most High. The synagogue of Satan was able to conceal many truths because many people refused to seek the Most High for themselves. The elect must be careful about the signs and wonders they are seeing today. The kingdom of darkness is broadening the road that leads to destruction with the false signs and lying wonders. Satan can grow a large army because of his deceptions. The workers of iniquity in Egypt were able to copy the miracles Aaron and Moses did to convince Pharaoh to let the Israelites go. If the workers of iniquity were imitating the Most High back then, what about today?
Then Pharaoh also called the wise men and the sorcerers. Now the magicians of Egypt, they also did in like manner with their enchantments. But they cast down every man his rod, and they became serpents. But Aaron's rod swallowed up their rods. And he hardened Pharaoh's heart, that he hearkened not unto them, as the Lord had said.
Israelites, get to know the Elohim of Israel by building a personal relationship. The scripture said, you will find the Most High if you look for him with all your heart. Do not get to know the Most High through the Messiah that came in his own name in religion. The Most High has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light to set you free from the bondage of sin in the beast system. The Most High said in the last days, he will pour out his spirit on his people. Israelites, take the time to listen to what the spirit of the Most High is saying to the remnant that is called after his name. The time has come for the people of the Most High to believe their Elohim without great signs and wonders.
And take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your heart be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life, and so that day come upon you unawares. For as a snare shall it come on all of them that dwell on the face of the whole earth. Watch ye therefore, and pray always that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man.